I'll check out that map.
You're the one who wanted to switch.
I think I hear someone. Someone's been watching us.
Playing a sick game with us.
You were right. This is right up. Chest wound is cause of death, but the corpse is bloated, waterlogged. Doesn't add up. There's definitely something in his chest. Did the killers leave it there? Type of page we found at Cauldron Lake.
Nightingale hunted Saga. Didn't see her. The Taken could not see into bright light. Light hurt them, made them vulnerable. Nightingale had no heart, but here he was, killing.
Someone's created a fucked up fantasy about us.
Hey, hold on. We found these kinds of pages. I didn't think they were relevant to this case. I have them right here.
My gun's out in the hall. Gotta get it back. Gotta move. Now.
Get out of my house!
grab to grab to you.
He didn't have a heart, but he still got up. The page predicted all of it. It helped me fight him.
He just disappeared? What the hell is going on here?
We need to figure that out if we're going to do anything about it. Somehow we need to make sense of this. There is no rational explanation to what we just saw.
I'd love to blame this on mass hallucination caused by inhaling volcanic gas, but we both know that's bullshit. This was supernatural.
Well, I'm glad you were the one to say it. Now we can figure out a way forward. Right before things got crazy, Sheriff Breaker just vanished.
Maybe the sheriff knew more than he was letting on.
He seemed anxious, like he dreaded what was coming. One more mystery. The victim of a ritualistic murder turns into a monster. Is there a connection?
Looks to me like the cult of the tree is performing rituals to create monsters.
Maybe. We need to start with learning this cult's goal, their purpose.
There's one of the pages on the floor.
These pages are important. Breaker dropped one before he disappeared.
Saga was back at Cauldron Lake. Saga had to pursue Nightingale into the overlap. Finding a way in would be difficult. A ritual. Saga would learn how. Stop the monster. The autopsy room was a mess, like a bomb had gone off. Nightingale hunted Saga, didn't see her under the light, lurched past her. The Taken could not see into bright light. The light hurt them, hurt the darkness in them, made them vulnerable. I flick the switch, it goes click. Show me the clicker, lights are off, but somebody's home. Hemingway brought you here, witch, get out of my house, Nightingale shouted. A wave of terror crashed through Saga's head. The awful truth. Nightingale had no heart in his chest, but here he was, killing a monster. The world had lurched out of balance. You found yourself trapped on the far side of the mirror. Saga was back at Cauldron Lake. He was there too. Nightingale was, but wasn't a Taken, a creature of darkness. He was beyond her reach, where some other strange reality, the Dark Place, merged with ours. This place and the Dark Place, a tarp thrown over top, drowning everything beneath it, a flood of darkness, soaking into everything, spoiling it, rotting it. The page called this area an overlap. Saga had to pursue Nightingale into the overlap. Finding a way in would be difficult, required precise steps, a ritual. Saga would learn how. Stop the monster before he killed again. Her job, he'd be inside, waiting for her.
Something feels different. I should look around. A charm. Cute. It'll go great on the bracelet Logan made for me. Huh. That was strange. Gotta keep an eye out for more.
The report of the shotgun rang in the air. The enemy fell. Saga felt a surge of new energy.
We're at the bottom of an ocean. It's not an ocean. And a lake. That's not a lake.
There was something hidden here, a phrase repeated over and over. The words resonated with meaning. Had I written this? The dark presence. I had seen it before. I remembered now. It was always out there.
Should ask around. Hey, this should get that gift shop open.
To protect myself. A gun and a flashlight. How nostalgic.
Casey, not until my family is safe from this horror story.
This was not the ritual murder site I was looking for. This had just been an appetizer before the main course. The devil walked through the hotel, dragging the whole place to hell with him. The devil's path up the staircase was draped in blood. I felt the presence of a new idea here.
Mr. Scratch, if that's who the actor playing the devil was, had stayed in the hotel. Asking around at reception got me a room number. 666. He had requested that room specifically. The devil had a sense of humor. Or he really didn't. It was funny either way. According to the director, the actor hadn't mingled with the rest of the cast. He had only come out for the play, and always in character.
Finch had been here. I could sense his presence lingering in the room. I was about to have another killer idea.
Let's talk about the murder victim. The lady who was killed in the climax of the play.
The leading lady. Oh, it was an honor to get to work with her. A grand dame for sure. She went back a long time. Kept insisting she had seen the long-lost original script of the play. She'd been with this mysterious writer, his muse. That was her role in the play. The muse.
She was staying in room 108, where the murder happened.
The set of the final scene, right. The devil comes, an unstoppable force crashing through the hotel through each scene, executed with devastating mastery, and all leading up to him meeting his muse. It turns out he knew her. He had only joined the play to get to her.
To murder her.
The dark presence had come for me, drawn to the story I was writing as it grew darker.
Soul. I don't have time for this, so let's get it over with. Tell me, was this all fake? A show?
No one said otherwise, Mr. Wake. It was to indulge you, but we can stop pretending now.
Masks come off.
Oh, I wouldn't go that far. I don't even think you know who's under your mask. But you know how to make things difficult for yourself. All these rules, endless, convoluted loops you insist on going through. You are so lucky, you know. There are so many people helping you. Armies of people. Myself. Your wife.
Alice. I need to get to her. She's in danger.
She is. Because of you. And so is someone important to me, someone you pulled into this. You keep opening doors, peeking in, reaching through to get what you want, and that puts you in my path.
I don't know what you're talking about. I have to go now.
Maybe you will make it through this time. This has gone on long enough. This and our Night Springs, it was a nice distraction.
It's time someone gave me a straight answer here.
The next time we meet, the circumstances will be very different. And you would do well to return the favor by playing your part. Or stay out of my way, Mr. Wake.
Whatever you say.
Door, Zane, the masks were finally coming off. Was it a sign I was closer to escaping? I had no time to waste.
Try anything, I will shoot you in the head! Scratch wrote return, not me! You're a fucking liar!
You'd given up. You stopped writing. You said it was too dangerous, that we didn't deserve to get out. And then he showed up. Scratch. He promised to write. To get me the hell out of here. He was magnificent. A visionary. Return and left me behind.
It's still here, and so is he.
I know I fucked up. But you can still catch him before he gets out, before he gets to your wife. And when you get to him, don't hesitate. Kill the bastard for what he did to us. There's a murder site in my cinema. Where my film Nightless Night is playing.
I told you not to try anything!
Mercy. thousands have gone missing beyond the labyrinth of me. When you're lost in your own company. And cut! Oh. Now that is drama.
What the fuck? I had a million questions about Zane. But I had more pressing concerns. Getting close.
Welcome, Alex Casey. You've done well. You've played your role perfectly.
Everything out of your mouth is a damn lie. The only place any of this makes any sense is in your psychotic brain.
As a fictional character in a story, you fulfilled your purpose. You brought the writer of the story here. You can go now, Casey.
No, I'm not going anywhere before I get some answers. How was I in that movie? Why does all this feel so familiar? What? Who the fuck are you? Who the fuck am I? No!
And welcome to you, Alan Wake.
What the hell?
This is the ritual to lead you on. We're just one step away from your final destination, Mr. Wake. But first, here's an unanswered mystery for you. If Casey was fictional, and you assumed his role as a detective, are you now fictional too? Whose story are you living, Mr. Wake?
The visions are getting under my skin. Coming too close for comfort. Not a separate layer, but mingling with my own reality in the dark place. Wait. Dead end. This can't be right. Did I miss something?
Saga Anderson, listen. I've been tricked. Scratch wrote returned. I tried to fix the story, but he stopped me before I reached the end. He has it now. It's the key to escape.
What do you mean, escape? You're with Scratch.
I need to stop him. I need to stop him before he gets out. He's after Alice. I'm still trapped, but I'm making progress. I wrote you in to be the story's hero. Scratch made a horror story. I need to match the genre. It has to be dark, but the hero can break through, save her family, save us all.
Save her family? Are you talking about my family?
Yes. Whatever you're doing, it's working. You just need to keep going.
Did we have family in the horror story?
I was closer now. Closer than ever before. But there was no time to lose. Everything was hanging in the balance. I could still lose it all. Parliament Tower. I had to make it work this time. I could stop Scratch, get the manuscript, fix its ending. I was traveling deeper into the dark place. The poem on the wall was growing at the same pace, dogging my footsteps, like my unwanted shadow moving in the corner of my eye. It wasn't my writing. I didn't know what it was. A terrible prophecy, a curse looming over me.
Onko täällä ketään? Ahti.
Sanovat, se joka varjoon tyytyy, valon ihmeestä paitsi jää.
Olisin mua ikävä.
Olit Veikon kanssa. Siksi lähdin.
Hän on poissa. Ollut jo kauan.
Kun nyt lähden. Lähde kanssani.
Mutta vasta tämän yön jälkeen.
Tuhoa ja pojan paluu. Ja häntä koipien välis. Tuliko hakemaan anteeksanta?
Muuten nyt mistään paluusta ovat ennenaikaisia. Tulin vain käymään. Nyt kun muistan millaista tämä touhu täällä on, en viivy kauaa. Missäs veljesi luuraa?
Pisti hengiltä. Rupes käymään aivoon se aina länkytys. Uhrilla ja mestarilla. Mutta ei se paskaveli kelvannut edes siihen. Sä olit mestarin valittu. Vaikka mä koskaan ymmärtänyt, että miksi. Päiviltä pitäisi sinutkin pistää. Miten on? Nyt tuli tupen rapinat, poika. Leikataan partaa!
Leikataan pojalta partaa!
Miksi palasit, kun kerran lähdit?
En aikonut. Mutta nyt löydän itseni täältä. Nyt on kai kirottu. Kirjoitettu sadistisen kirjailijan tarina. Kierrän kehää.
Maa on syklinen laulu. Mites siellä valtion kontrollivirastossa menee?
Väärä virasto. En ole siellä töissä. Sitä paitsi, sain potkut. Ei olisi tarvetta talonmiehen apulaiselle.
Ei ole. Tämän tilan isäntä katosi yön selkää vuosia sitten. Sen jälkeen, kun sinä lähdit. Merkit on ilmassa, että multakin loppuu hommat pian. Siksi kyselen virastosta. Ehkä saan sieltä töitä.
Malja.
Mille juomme?
Yöttämälle yölle. Vie sinut tuon puoleiseen.
Sanotaan, että Aleen kurkotti liian pitkälle yön syövereihin. Eikä löytänyt sieltä enää pois. Kannattaa varoa sitä Aleenin mustaa leskeä. Taisit olla vähän heikkona häneen.
Pelkäsin häntä.
Me pojat oltiin aina vähän toivottomia naisten kanssa. Ha ha ha.